prepare to be shocked as we delve into the darkest corners of reality. In today's video, we bring you 5 bone-chilling, spine-tingling, and absolutely terrifying real-life stories that sent shockwaves through the world and dominated the headlines. Don't miss out on these tales. Let's begin. In 2019, a 20-year-old woman and her roommates from the University of North Carolina believed they had a ghost living in their off-campus apartment. This belief stemmed from the woman noticing her clothes disappearing from her closet and finding unexplained handprints on the bathroom wall. One Saturday, when the woman named Maddie returned to her apartment, she heard noises coming from her closet. To investigate, she asked, "Who's there?" Surprisingly, a male voice named Drew responded from inside the closet. Maddie opened the closet door and discovered a man hiding in the corner, wearing some of her clothes. She immediately contacted her boyfriend, who quickly arrived at the apartment and forced the man to leave. The police were called, but they couldn't determine how 30-year-old Andrew Clyde Swofford had entered the apartment since there were no signs of forced entry. Swofford was arrested shortly after the incident and charged with misdemeanor breaking and entering.
Open the door and he's in there wearing all of my clothes, my socks, my shoes, has a book bag full of my clothes.
Police say that was 30-year-old Andrew Swofford.
Victoria Roth and her co-worker were staying at a hotel on a work trip when something terrible happened. After a long day, they returned to their hotel room, and Roth noticed a woman in the bathroom holding her clothes. At first, Roth thought it was housekeeping, but when the woman tried to push past her, she knew something was wrong. Roth searched the woman's bag, but found nothing of hers and let her leave. Later, Roth discovered that her hotel room had been ransacked and some of her medicine was missing. She called the police, but they found no signs of forced entry. Roth had a hunch and moved the mirror over the sink, revealing a massive hole behind it containing pillows, blankets, clothes, and more. It was later discovered that the woman had access to other rooms through holes left in the walls after renovations, which the hotel had covered up with mirrors. On November 12, 2018, Jason Cameron Stiles, 30, entered a 20-year-old Denver woman's bedroom and attacked her in an attempt to overpower her. Luckily, the woman fought back and Stiles fled the scene. The police arrested Stiles shortly after the attack and found a knife and latex gloves on him. Stiles' handgun was found outside the woman's home. During the investigation, Stiles admitted to breaking into the woman's home multiple times before the attack and taking photographs of her possessions, including several pages from her journal. He also hid in her closet, watching her get undressed, brush her teeth, and sleep. It was believed that Stiles had been stalking the woman for over a year before breaking into her home for the first time. Stiles was found guilty of first-degree burglary, stalking, and a crime of violence, and was sentenced to 16 years in prison.
One of the scary things about this situation is we could never really figure out how he was getting into the apartment. I think we assumed that he was getting the garage code somehow, either by watching her enter it or something like that, and came through the garage door, but there was no really signs of entry.
Timothy Smith and his fiancée celebrated the closing of their first home in Gresham in July 2019. Upon arriving at their house with some relatives on a Sunday afternoon, they found a MacBook Pro, an open bottle of cider, and an assortment of knives on top of their parked car. Assuming that neighbors or friends had left the items, they brought them inside. However, upon entering the house, Smith noticed something was wrong. There was an unfamiliar vape pen on their kitchen table, a missing heating grate, and holes in several walls. In the bathroom, they found a stranger's clothes on top of their washing machine. In the third bedroom, Smith found the hatch to a crawl space open and discovered a cat wearing clothes that belonged to one of his chihuahuas. He called 911. The police arrived 15 minutes later and led a man wearing Smith's fiancée's onesie out of the house. The man, later identified as Ryan Bishop, had broken through several walls over 3 hours, drank beer, ate cupcakes, smoked weed, and played video games. Smith decided to keep the cat found with the man until its owner could be identified.
So he came in and he made himself a cup of coffee. This is actually all, like, he was only here for 3 hours and he managed to drink all of these. He pulled the cupcakes out of the fridge, ate a few of those.
In December 2019, Zacharias Adrian Cavazos, who was 21 years old, met a girl through social media. He traveled from Washington to the girl's home on the Umatilla Indian Reservation in Oregon shortly after. In early February, he met up with the girl and convinced her to let him into her home. Without the girl's grandfather knowing, Cavazos moved into her bedroom. However, on February 25th, the grandfather saw Cavazos in the house and chased him away, warning him to stay away from his granddaughter. Despite the warning, Cavazos ignored it and sneaked back into the house almost immediately. He hid in the girl's room until March 11th, 2020, using spots under the bed and in the closet in case someone else entered the room. Eventually, the grandfather discovered Cavazos hiding in the room again and called the police. After his arrest, Cavazos confessed to having sexual relations with the girl multiple times while living in her room. At the time, Cavazos had been released to a clean and sober house while awaiting trial.